A very good morning to our viewers. I'm Smriti Rastogi with Breakfast News. Our top focus this morning is the latest from the farmers' protest in Madhya Pradesh and the ground situation in Darjeeling. Before getting you all the details, a quick look at the top headlines. Farmers' organizations to meet in Delhi to decide future course of action. MP Chief Minister to sit on fast. Two farmers commit suicide in Maharashtra and Madhya Pradesh. Darjeeling SP removed. Mamata Banerjee seeks special audit of Gorkha Territorial Administration finances. GJM alleges Trinamool triggered violence. Army foils infiltration bid along the line of control. Six militants eliminated in Uri in Baramulla district. Theresa May says she will form government with backing of DUP Party of Ireland, insists despite poll results, Brexit talks will begin as planned. And Rafael Nadal to meet Stan Wawrinka in men's singles final at the French Open. Simona Halep and Jelena Ostapenko to clash for women's title today. As the farmers' agitation is gaining heat in Madhya Pradesh, Chief Minister Shivraj Singh Chauhan has announced to sit on a fast from today. Meanwhile, the centre has asked states adjoining Madhya Pradesh to keep strict vigil against the spread of the protest. Around 62 farmers' organisations from various states will meet in Delhi to decide the future course of action. The situation in the parts of Madhya Pradesh's Mandsaur remained tense but under control with no report of fresh incidents of unrest. As Mandsaur in Madhya Pradesh remains on the boil, Chief Minister Shivraj Singh Chauhan announced that he will sit on a fast from today and hear the farmers' grievances. Chauhan has promised to bring in a loan settlement scheme for farmers who defaulted on repayment. Promising a better price for their crops, the state government has constituted a 1,000 crore rupees price stabilization fund to help farmers. Appealing for peace, Chauhan said that his government will sternly deal with anti-social elements who are resorting to violence amid the farmers' agitation.
कल 11 बजे से मैं यहाँ नहीं बैठूंगा, बल्लभ भवन में नहीं बैठूंगा, मैं भैल के दशहरा मैदान पर बैठूंगा, जनता से किसानों से चर्चा करने के लिए बैठूंगा, मैं सभी लोगों से अपील करता हूँ जो आंदोलन कर रहे हैं, आंदोलन अराजक हो गया है. आंदोलन स्थगित करें, चर्चा के लिए आगे आए. जो जायज चीजें उन पर चर्चा करने में मुझे कोई परेशानी नहीं, आखिर लोकतंत्र में चर्चा से ही समस्या का समाधान होता है.
द सेंटर हैज आस्क्ड द स्टेट्स एडजॉइनिंग मध्य प्रदेश टू कीप स्ट्रिक्ट विजिल अगेंस्ट द स्प्रेड ऑफ फार्मर्स प्रोटेस्ट. द गवर्नमेंट इज इन टच विद उत्तर प्रदेश, राजस्थान एंड महाराष्ट्र एंड सेंसिटाइजिंग देम अगेंस्ट एनी पॉसिबल प्रोटेस्ट बाय फार्मर्स. The Home Ministry has also dispatched around 200 personnel of the Anti-Riots Rapid Action Force to Madhya Pradesh. On the other hand, Congress in Gujarat has warned of launching state-wide farmers' protest.
कुछ राजनीतिक पार्टियां जो कि आंदोलन को अनावश्यक हवा देने की कोशिश कर रही हैं राजनीतिक स्वार्थवश, मैं समझता हूं उन्हें बचना चाहिए, किसानों के हितों से खिलवाड़ नहीं करना चाहिए.
And on the day of the election, President Prime Minister promised that if they come back, they will waive the loan. So they were doing politics, not we are.
In a related development, two farmers have died in MP, one in Badawan village. The police say the circumstances of the death are unclear. Locals claim that he was thrashed by policemen on Thursday evening. A 45-year-old debt-ridden farmer also allegedly committed suicide in Sagonia village. The farmers' agitation reached the doorsteps of Bhopal on Friday with incidents of arson and stone pelting in Fanda area. Police baton charged the protesters and arrested at least 27 of them in the area.
लागत बढ़ रही है, लागत दिन पे दिन महंगाई हो रही है. पैकिंग सामान का तो सरकार भाव फिक्स कर रही है, पर किसान का कोई भाव नहीं है. किसान गड्ढे में जाता ही जा रहा है.
इनके बारे में सर अभी तो कुछ किसानों के लिए तो कुछ किया पहुँच ही नहीं पाए ना सर. अभी तक तो कुछ नहीं पहुँच पाए किसानों के पास तो कि सर कुछ नहीं है ना सर. अभी क्या है, आप मुआवजा माफ करने की बोला था कि बीमा ये करेंगे माफ कर देंगे, अभी तक कुछ नहीं हुआ.
Taking a cue from the farmers' protest in Madhya Pradesh, their counterparts in Uttar Pradesh and Tamil Nadu have also swung into action. Farmers' bodies in UP have warned of protests. Expressing solidarity with the farmers of Mandsaur, UP farmers have threatened to cut off supply of daily essentials to cities from Sunday if the demand for a CBI probe into the police firing in Mandsaur is not met. Farmers in Tamil Nadu launched an indefinite protest in Chennai, pressing for their demands, including comprehensive drought relief. The protesters, led by P. Akkaiyakannu, who had spearheaded a 40-day stir in New Delhi in April, urged the government to look into demands of loan waiver, drought relief package and setting up of the Kaveri Management Board.
Please keep your promise, withdraw the case from the Supreme Court and give the pension to the farmers, those who are above 60 years, even they have the son, even they have the daughter, even they have the patta lands, because the beggar is better than the farmer. Because we have no income at all. So we are demanding the central government give profitable price to the farmers. Till that we ask them the right of loans.
The farmers' agitation in the country worsened this week after 5 farmers and MPs Mandsaur were killed in police firing during protests demanding farm loan waiver.
Amidst the allegations and counter-allegations clamour of politicians, the life in Mandsaur is gradually coming back to the normalcy. But the farmer leaders who has been spearheading this whole agitation are saying that the amelioration of the pecuniary condition of the debt-ridden farmer is still a distant reality. In Mandsaur, with camera person Sanjay Kumar, Ravindra Singh Shoran for Rajya Sabha TV.
And for more on this story, we'll go across to our correspondent, Ravindra Singh Shoran, who is joining us on phone line. Ravindra, tell us about the ground situation in Mandsaur right now.
Yeah, good morning, Smriti. The curfew, which has been relaxed yesterday for 8 hours, today has been extended for 4 more hours. And today the curfew will remain relaxed for 12 hours in this Mandsaur, the violent hit Mandsaur district of Madhya Pradesh. Mandsaur is the center now, the nerve center, the epicenter of the whole agitation, which has already been spread out in the whole of the Madhya Pradesh. And even some of the unions, some of the Kisan unions, the farmer unions who have been agitating across the country, they have also extended their support to the farmers who has been agitating in Madhya Pradesh. And this announcement has been making the administration on the tenterhooks. The senior administration officials are in talk with the chief ministers and senior ministers, and they are closely watching the situation. After the curfew, which has been lifted yesterday and today also, the supply of vital goods, dairy products and vegetables has also been restored, and the life is gradually coming to the normalcy. But the administration has still remained, as I told you, even the farmers' organization from neighboring states, they have also extended their support. And they are going to meet to the agitating farmers in Mandsaur, and they are going to visit to the families of the victim as well. And they are planning a gherav of this area in the next week. Also, despite as the senior leaders of many various political parties, they have also visited here. The chief minister himself is today sitting on a fast, and he has also extended an invitation for the dialogue to the farmer leaders.
Ravindra, thank you so much for joining us and giving us all those latest information from that development from Mandsaur. And moving on, the SP of Darjeeling has been removed following the protest and band called by Gorkha Janmukti Morcha on Friday. Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee took stock of the situation last night and ordered an audit of finances of the Gorkha Territorial Administration. The GJM, on the other hand, blamed the TMC for instigating violence. The army was also called out in many parts of Darjeeling and adjacent areas to maintain law and order.
A day after Gorkha Janmukti Morcha volunteers triggered violence in the towns, Darjeeling, Kalimpong and Kursiang observed a general shutdown on Friday. The roads were deserted as vehicles stopped plying. The state government requisitioned army presence in the areas near the border with Nepal and Bhutan. Tourists remained stranded at the Bagdogra airport. The airport authorities said adequate arrangements were made for passengers.
सामने तो हम तो होटल में थे तो साइड में बसें चला दी थी ऊपर से धुएं दिख रहे थे फिर आंसू वाले बम फेंक रहे थे तो इतना बस यही पता चला कि गोरखा लैंड की शायद मांग कर रहे थे वो लोग, और ममता बनर्जी आई थी तो उसके खिलाफ प्रोटेस्ट था।
तो आप लोग कब वहाँ से निकल के कैसे भागे वहाँ?
हम रात को ही सुबह 2 बजे ही हमने टैक्सी करी यहाँ पे आए, फिर यहाँ पे सुबह से रुके।
आज के लिए जो हम लोगों ने किया कि नॉर्मली जो एयरपोर्ट 9 या 10 बजे तक ऑपरेशनल होता है, वो हम लोगों ने पैसेंजर की सुविधा को ध्यान में रखते हुए हमने आज एयरपोर्ट को 5 बजे से ही सभी जो सुविधाएं हैं सबको उपलब्ध करा दी थी। जैसे कि पैसेंजर यहाँ पहला तो आराम से एंटर करके यहाँ पे वेट कर सकते हैं, जो रेस्टोरेंट की सुविधा होती है, और जो हमारे हाउसकीपिंग स्टाफ है, जो सिक्योरिटी है, और जो हमारा मे आई हेल्प यू काउंटर है जो कि किसी को कोई इंक्वायरी करनी है, वो सब फैसिलिटी मॉर्निंग में 5 बजे से उपलब्ध थी।
West Bengal Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee, who was stranded in the hills, descended to the plains of Darjeeling district last night and took stock of the situation. She has been in the city for the last 3 days for a cabinet meeting. She has sought a special audit report of the Gorkha Janmukti Morcha-led Gorkhaland Territorial Administration's handling of finances within another 2 weeks. The GTA term is set to end in July.
I'm told, loke bolchi, khobor ta etai. Darjeeling o 30% eto কিছু করেও রিগিং করে টাকা বিলিয়ে পয়সা দিয়েও 30% লোক ভোট দেয়নি। কালিম্পংয়ে যদি টোটাল বিরোধী ভোট যোগ করো তাহলে ওদের থেকে অনেক বেশি। কার্শিয়াংও তাই, মিরিকেও হেরে গেছে। সুতরাং এই যে একটা ঘা খেয়েছে প্রথম পাল, পাহাড়ে একটা গণতান্ত্রিক পদ্ধতি, একটা প্রক্রিয়া যেটা মানুষ নিজের রায় দিয়েছে, সেটাতে ভয় পেয়ে গেছে।
The state government also blamed Gorkha Janmukti Morcha and Gorkha Territorial Authority Chief Bimal Gurung for the situation. Also, the Superintendent of Police of Darjeeling has been removed from his post.
তিনি পাহাড়কে একটা নতুন ডাইমেনশন দিচ্ছেন, নতুনভাবে পাহাড়কে সাজিয়ে তুলছেন। সেই সময় জনবিচ্ছিন্নতায় ভুগে বিমল গুরুং অ্যান্ড কোম্পানি তারা যে হিংসাত্মক ঘটনা করেছে এটা শুধু নিন্দনীয় নয়, এটা কোনো রাজনীতি নয়, এটা হুলিগানিজম।
লেকিন ইয়ে সৃষ্টি টিএমসি কা তরফ সে হো গিয়া। হাম লোগ তো একদম শান্তি ঢঙ্গ সে ওয়াহ পর এক গণতান্ত্রিক ঢঙ্গ সে হাম লোগ কাম কর রহা থা। অচানক উপর মে মহাকাল থান সে ওয়াহ সে পথরবাজি কিয়া टीएमसी का 4-5 लड़का लोग, और उसका बाद में हम लोग का बच्चे लोग का ऊपर में भी लगा और पुलिस का ऊपर में भी लगा, और पुलिस ने समझा हम लोग ने मारा और हम लोग ने समझा पुलिस ने मारा, ये विवाद हुआ। लेकिन ये सब एक क्रिएट किया हुआ चीज़ है।
The Gorkha Territorial Authority blamed Mamata for trying to impose her will on the hilly areas. They're also protesting against the imposition of Bengali as a second language in the hills, although the chief minister later said it would be optional.
आप इंग्लिशी पढ़ो, हिंदी पढ़ो, नेपाली पढ़ो, जो मर्जी पढ़ो, लेकिन 10 क्लास तक वो आपको सीबीएसई में भी नहीं देना पड़ेगा, आपको आईसीएसई में बोर्ड का परीक्षा नहीं देना पड़ेगा, लेकिन 10 क्लास तक कम से कम एक लैंग्वेज का ऑप्शन रखो, इसी के लिए जैसे आपको नौकरी का फायदा मिले। और दिस इज ऑप्शनल, दिस इज नॉट कंपल्सरी, दिस इज ऑप्शनल।
और अभी जो स्टेट गवर्नमेंट है, रूलिंग जो पार्टी है, ये लोग भी चाहते हैं कि हिल का जो पॉलिटिकल पावर इन लोग का हाथ में आए, ताकि वो हिल का अपने तरीका से चला सके। लेकिन हिल का जो पीपल है ये लोग नहीं चाहते हैं, ये लोग चाहते हैं कि हिल का जो सिचुएशन, हिल का जो आदमी का जो सेंटिमेंट, ये हिल्स का जो है वो लोग अच्छे तरह सोच पाएंगे, इन लोग के लिए थोड़ा कुछ कर पाएंगे वहाँ का सिचुएशन के लिए। इसमें ये कॉन्फ्लिक्ट अराइज हो रहा है और इसीलिए टेंशन भी हो रहा है।
The problems in the hills have been festering ever since Mamata Banerjee won the Mirik constituency in a recent bipoll. The area is a BJP stronghold represented by its MP SS Ahluwalia.
Everyone knows that this is the time when most of the tourists visit Darjeeling, North Bengal and even Sikkim, because this is the route of all these areas where people come in summer. And this is the time when common people gets benefited in this area. But people are telling that due to clash of ego between Mamata Banerjee and Bimal Gurung, the whole of hilly areas are now empty and people are coming off there. People are at a loss. Who will pay for this loss is a big question. Akhilesh Soman for Rajya Sabha Television with camera person Sudhanshu in Siliguri.
On to some more news. Chairman of Naga Rebel Group, NSCNK, SS Khaplang, passed away on Friday. He is responsible for engineering many attacks on security forces, including the killing of 18 army soldiers in Manipur. He passed away at the age of 77 in Myanmar. Official sources said he was ailing for quite some time and died following a cardiac arrest. SS Khaplang was a Hemi Naga from Myanmar and was based mostly there, where the outfit maintains several camps. Since 1980s, the outfit has engaged in subversive activities, including attacks on security forces, extortion and looting. Following the Manipur ambush in 2015, in which 18 personnel were killed, the Indian Army carried out cross-border raids on NSCNK camps located inside Myanmar. The ambush on the army was carried out by the group despite it being involved in peace negotiations with the interlocutor of the central government. The government has snapped the dialogue and in September 2015 and declared that the outfit an unlawful organization for 5 years. SS Khaplang joined the Naga Nationalist Movement as early as 1964 and was one of the key people in the formation of the NSCN. However, Khaplang split and formed his own group, NSCNK, in 1988. The ruling Biju Janata Dal called for a 4-hour hartal today in 4 western Odisha districts over the Mahanadi water dispute with a neighbouring Chhattisgarh. The hartal was observed for 4 hours from 6 a.m. till 10 a.m. today in Sambalpur, Bargarh, Jharsuguda and Sonepur. Essential services will be exempted from the strike. The BJD has accused the NDA government at centre of supporting the BJP government in Chhattisgarh for unilaterally and illegally constructing 6 barrages on upstream of water river Mahanadi. Odisha Chief Minister Naveen Patnaik on June 3rd had written to Chhattisgarh Chief Minister asking him to immediately open the gates of Kalma Barrage and ensure free flow of water. As Chhattisgarh government closed the gates of Kalma Barrage, the people of Sambalpur, Jharsuguda, Bargarh and Sonepur and many other districts have been facing acute drinking water shortage. And on to the latest from Jammu and Kashmir. The army foiled another infiltration bid along the line of control as it took down 6 militants in Uri sector in Baramulla district on Friday. It was the 5th infiltration bid foiled by the army in 3 days, in which a total of 13 militants have been killed. Multiple attempts of infiltration across the line of control were made, which were foiled at Machil and Nogam sectors in Kupwara district and Gurez in Bandipura district. Army said that the terrorist groups were being provided active support, including cover fire by the Pakistan Army, to assist infiltration into the Kashmir Valley. Home Minister Rajnath Singh said that the country's borders were more secured than before and would be further fortified to stop infiltration. A day earlier, the Home Minister had said that he was ready for talks with everyone to resolve the Kashmir issue, adding that he will not put any conditions for the purpose.
हमारी तरफ से पहली गोली नहीं चलनी चाहिए, यही है हमारी सरकार का मानना है, सबका मानना है, क्योंकि हम पड़ोसियों के साथ अच्छे रिश्ते बनाकर रखना चाहते हैं। लेकिन यदि चल गई तो फिर अपना सेना और सुरक्षा के जवानों का हाथ बढ़ा नहीं है, लेकिन पहली गोली हम लोग नहीं चलाएंगे।
Meanwhile, India and Pakistan became full members of the Shanghai Cooperation Organization at the Astana Summit on Friday. Speaking at the summit, Prime Minister Narendra Modi said that India may have got the membership now, but India's relationship with the group are long-standing. He also asserted that connectivity among the SCO nations remains the top priority for India.
हमारी सदस्यता के समर्थन के लिए मैं SCO के सभी देशों का हार्दिक आभार प्रकट करता हूं।
Prime Minister Narendra Modi thanking all the members of the Shanghai Cooperation Organization for their support after India became a member on Friday. In his address at the annual summit, Modi pitched for coordinated efforts among SCO members to combat terrorism. He hoped that India's entry into the bloc will give a new momentum to the group in dealing with terrorism.
आतंकवाद तथा अतिवाद के खिलाफ संघर्ष एससीओ के सहयोग का अहम भाग है। मुद्दा चाहे रेडिकलाइजेशन का हो, टेररिस्ट की रिक्रूटमेंट का, उनकी ट्रेनिंग का अथवा फाइनेंसिंग का, जब तक हम सभी देश मिलकर इस दिशा में कोऑर्डिनेटेड तथा सशक्त एफर्ट्स नहीं करेंगे तब तक इन समस्याओं का समाधान असंभव है.
मोदी स्पोक ऑन द नीड टू एनहांस कनेक्टिविटी इन द रीजन एंड सेड इट वॉज द की टू बूस्ट ट्रेड एंड इन्वेस्टमेंट. He also called for efforts by the SCO to tackle climate change.
हम चाहते हैं कि कनेक्टिविटी हमारे देशों की भावी पीढ़ियों तथा समाजों के बीच सहयोग तथा विश्वास का मार्ग प्रशस्त करे. इसके लिए कनेक्टिविटी इनिशिएटिव्स अथवा परियोजनाओं की सफलता एवं स्वीकृति के लिए संप्रभुता तथा क्षेत्रीय अखंडता का आदर जरूरी तथा इनकी इंक्लूसिविटी तथा सस्टेनेबिलिटी आवश्यक है.
Earlier, Modi met Chinese President Xi Jinping on the sidelines. They discussed bilateral matters and geopolitical developments in the region. This was the first meeting between the two after India stayed away from the One Belt, One Road Forum in Beijing last month.
Time of global uncertainty. India-China relations are a factor of stability. And as the world becomes more multipolar, it was important for India and China to work together more closely. I think there was also an understanding that where we have differences, it was important that differences should not become disputes.
Modi also met Uzbek President Shavkat Mirziyoyev on the sidelines of the SCO. The Prime Minister arrived in the Kazakh capital on Thursday for the two-day summit. Pakistan also joined the SCO as a member on Friday. India's membership was strongly pushed by Russia, while Pakistan's entry was backed by China. Bureau report, Rajya Sabha TV.
And shifting our focus to the international front, after the snap election that saw UK's conservative majority in the House of Commons shrink to a minority, Prime Minister Theresa May says that her party will form government with the backing of DUP Party of Ireland. The Prime Minister insists that despite the poll result, Brexit talks would begin on 19th of June as planned. But with a cabinet reshuffle and new Brexit goals likely after the election results, that timetable now seems unrealistic.
British Prime Minister Theresa May leaving her Downing Street residence from a back entrance. This after her Conservative Party failed to get an absolute majority in the snap polls, getting 318 seats, 8 short of the 326 needed to secure a Commons majority. May had called the election early to shore up support for the Conservatives ahead of the Brexit negotiations. But the move backfired. However, May insists that she will put together a government with the support of the DUP, a socially conservative party that represents those who want Northern Ireland to remain a part of the UK.
At this time, more than anything else, this country needs a period of stability. And if, as the indications have shown, if this is correct, that the Conservative Party has won the most seats, and probably the most votes, then it will be incumbent on us to ensure that we have that period of stability.
But Labour Party says it was the real winner. Denouncing May's plan to head up a minority government, the party says it was ready to form a minority government of its own.
The Prime Minister called the election because she wanted a mandate. Well, the mandate she's got is lost Conservative seats, lost votes, lost support and lost confidence. I would have thought that's enough to go, actually, and make way for a government that will be truly representative of all of the people of this country.
With the election result, though, Britain's exit from the European Union has been plunged into uncertainty. Formal talks on the UK leaving the EU are due to start on 19th of June. EU officials say May can postpone the date if she needs to. But with the final deadline for exiting the EU in March 2019, precious negotiating time would be lost if delayed.
The European Commission are ready to do business and ready to start negotiations. We hope that the UK will be able to form a stable government as soon as possible. And our negotiating team, headed by Michel Barnier, is very well prepared.
The Prime Minister is clear that, you know, she's planning to press ahead with her objectives and her strategy for Brexit, but she is obviously now in a weaker position domestically, probably on some of the detail of what our future relationship with the EU is going to look like. She might come under pressure to go for a softer form of exit.
May has already ruled out a major cabinet reshuffle, and most of the senior government members will maintain their posts. But before the Queen can open the new parliament on 19th of June, the same day Brexit talks were meant to start, May first needs to draw up a budget and flesh out the policies of her manifesto to put in the Queen's speech. It is all a distraction at a pressure time for the Prime Minister. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
US President Donald Trump has denied that he told ex-FBI chief James Comey to drop an investigation into a former national security advisor, adding he was willing to give his version of events under oath. Trump said he was 100% willing to speak under oath about his conversations with Comey. Speaking at the White House, he denied having asked for Comey's loyalty. Comey says Trump fired him because of his Russia inquiry. The former FBI chief was investigating an alleged Kremlin plot to sway last year's US elections in favor of Trump and whether there was any collusion with the president or his campaign staff. On Thursday, Comey testified to one of the several congressional committees that is also looking into the Russian claims. He said the president had pressured him to drop a probe into the former national security advisor Michael Flynn.
So he said those things under oath. Would you be willing to speak under oath to give your version of those events? 100%.
I didn't say under oath. I hardly know the man. I'm not going to say, I want you to pledge allegiance. Who would do that? Who would ask a man to pledge allegiance under oath? I mean, think of it. I hardly know the man. It doesn't make sense. No, I didn't say that, and I didn't say the other.
In the ICC Champions Trophy, Bangladesh produced a historic batting performance to stun New Zealand by 5 wickets in Group A encounter at Cardiff. Opting to bat first, New Zealand started steadily and looked poised for a big score towards the end. But some disciplined bowling from Bangladesh saw Kiwis totals restricted to 265 for 8. Captain Kane Williamson and Ross Taylor scored half centuries for their side. In reply, Bangladesh had a horrible start after they were reduced to 12 for 3 by some super bowling by Tim Southey. However, a record stand of 224 between Shakib Al-Hassan and Mahmudullah, both of whom hit centuries, saw the Tigers complete a stunning win with 16 balls remaining. The result eliminated New Zealand from the tournament but kept the Asian side hopes alive. Bangladesh will qualify for the semi-finals if England beats Australia in today's match at Birmingham. The host England have already qualified for the last four with 2 wins from 2 games. And 9-time champion Rafael Nadal will meet world number 3 Stan Wawrinka in the men's singles final at the French Open on Sunday. In a Friday's semi-final, Wawrinka defeated world number 1 Andy Murray in a grueling 5-set encounter. The 2015 champion Wawrinka was 2-1 down before coming back to win 6-7, 6-3, 5-7, 7-6, 6-1 in a match that lasted more than 4.5 hours. The Swiss hit staggering 87 winners in the victory to reach the second Roland Garros final in 3 years. In the second semi-final, Spain's world number 4 Nadal beat Austrian Dominic Thiem in the straight sets to remain on course for a record 10th French Open title. The 31-year-old Nadal, who is yet to drop a set in this year's tournament, won comfortably 6-3, 6-4, 6-0 against world number 6 Thiem, who had knocked out defending champion Novak Djokovic in the quarterfinals. A victory in the final will make Nadal first man in history to win 10 titles at one Grand Slam. In the women's semi-finals today, Simona Halep takes on Jelena Ostapenko. And that's all we have for you in this edition of Breakfast News. Keep watching Rajya Sabha Television.